It's Monday, August 30th, 2010. I'm Kevin McShan, and this is the McShan Sports Beat Report.
Travel on, there's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore, where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today, yeah.
Dedication is not what others expect of you, but rather what you give to others. And for Detroit Tigers manager Jim Leyland, his dedication and commitment to the Old English D was on display yet again on Sunday afternoon when he proclaimed he wanted to be the manager in the Motor City, now and well into the future. The Tigers skipper will be 66 next season. He's also scheduled to enter the final year of his contract in 2011. One of the reasons he says he wants to stick around is because he's excited about what the future holds for the Tigers. "Yeah, I want to manage," Leland said, "but I'll leave that up to somebody else. This team has a chance to be good for quite a while, but I'm not going to go into that because that's down the road," he said. He says that the upcoming offseason will provide the Tigers with several opportunities to improve the quality of their roster. "This will probably be the most interesting offseason for our ball club since I've been here. I think our club has a chance to get really good really fast, and that's encouraging," Leland said. The team's roster figures to go under a dramatic transformation this offseason, with nearly $60 million in dead salary cap money coming off the books and several questions permeating throughout the roster on a countless number of players. Some of the more interesting storylines we'll all be following this offseason include the futures of utility men Ryan Rayburn and Don Kelly, not to mention what does the team plan to do at the shortstop position, where they have prospect Danny Worth and Johnny Peralta, who they acquired during the trading deadline from the Indians, and Alex Avila's future at catcher is still undetermined. However, perhaps the biggest question surrounding Detroit this winter is whether or not rookie slugger Brendan Bosch is indeed the real deal, and if he could provide consistent protection for all-star Miguel Cabrera. Leyland says that he believes that several of the Tigers' unanswered questions will come into better focus during the team's organizational winter meetings in Lakeland, Florida. They'll be conducted by Tigers general manager and president Dave Dombrowski. We really haven't had our meetings yet, Leyland said, and I'm sure Dave probably has his own ideas. It's a lot of fun, Leyland said, referring to his current mix of players on his roster, which is filled with plenty of youth, which will be evaluated closely in September once rosters expand. He says that 2011 has a lot to do with what's happening in the here and now. Leyland says, despite the fact he'll be 66 in December, his energy level remains at an all-time high, and he's more committed than ever to turning around the Tigers and making them a consistent winner. I feel great. I enjoy these guys. If my energy runs out, they won't have to tell me to go home or go home. But I haven't reached that point. I love what I'm doing, he said. Leyland is only 23 victories shy from recording his 1,500th win as a manager. During his 5-plus seasons in Motown, he has an overall mark of 408 and 371. He says he has an overwhelming desire to win the World Series with the Tigers. He accomplished the feat in 1997 when he was the manager of the Florida Marlins. He took the Tigers to the Fall Classic in 2006, where they lost to the St. Louis Cardinals in 5 games. Loyalty is a trait in a man's character which will inspire boundless hope. And there's no denying the fact that Leyland has been unwaveringly loyal to the Tigers and their organization over the past 5 seasons. And now, we'll all sit back and watch to find out if he can get a return on his investment and whether or not the Tigers front office can deliver him a roster which can consistently get into the win column in 2011. Dave Dombrowski, the focus is now squarely on you. Kevin McShan, McShan Sports Beat Report.